Hey guys, welcome back to yet another exciting video. I hope you all liked, shared and commented on all my previous videos. If you haven't watched it yet, go ahead and watch it, but pause this video. Yes guys, welcome back once again. Like, it's been a long time taking a video in my home because been traveling for the past 3-4 weeks, short trips and a bit long rides as well, like close to 100 kilometers or 80-90, which is pretty much like enough for this particular season, lockdown season. So yeah, so currently from past last week and today the date is 20, that's a Monday. So the thing is, the lockdown is going on. It's going in Bangalore till the Thursday 23rd, if I'm not wrong. So let's see what they have decided post that. You'll have to plan trips accordingly. I don't encourage going on a short rides or long rides. Let me stay for another 6 months, or let this year go and let's see how it goes. So today's video is about the basic 6 points that you all need to know before buying a new bike. So yeah, let's get into the video. Point one is choose your budget. After firming up your decision to buy a new bike, you should first choose a budget and set a limit. The amount of money that you can spend on your bike will help you narrow down on your options. Say for example, your budget is 1 lakh and the maximum that you can stretch up to is 1,50,000. Once this is done, you'll have to list out all the bike categories that comes under this budget, and like let's say you choose 10 bikes according to the cc that you need and according to the budget that you want, and list out all the bikes and choose the best among these. Point 2. Eliminate what you don't want. Now, instead of choosing the bike that you like, first eliminate the bikes that you don't like. For example, out of the 10 bikes that is listed, you may not want to buy some bikes of certain brands. Strike them out. You may not like the looks of some bikes. Again, scratch them out of the list. Bring the list down to 3 to 5 bike models, and if it satisfies your needs, choose the best among them and go ahead with it. Point 3 is read reviews. The next step is to hop onto the internet and start reading reviews of all of these motorcycles and scooters that you have chosen. By reviews, what I mean is go through the stories from automotive portals and also automotive portals to get intricate details. But more importantly, what you actually need to do is go through the actual and true testaments that's been given on the pros and cons of these motorcycles, which will help you to get in-depth details of all of these bikes. Fourth point is go and test ride these bikes. Find the best nearest showroom and test ride these bikes. A bike is something of value and emotional attachment, so it's good to feel it before buying it. Understand the concept that the most highlighted positive comment given by someone might be a con for you, because everybody's body structure, fit and you know, expectation is different. So out of the 3 to 5 bikes that you have tested now, you'll have to choose any two among them and think wisely and choose the best bike that suits your needs. The fourth point is fuel efficiency is important, but that should not be only criteria. I see most of us go through the mileage aspect, like most of them out there, including me at times. We see which bike gives the more mileage and things like that. So let's take an example. For example, you're buying a bike of costing you around 1 lakh and the mileage that the bike provides is 40 kmpl. Okay? And you're a person who travels around 1000 km a month, which is you'll have to fill 25 liters of petrol in a month. So considering the present petrol price of 80 or 83, let's round it up to 80, and you'll have to fill, so considering the present price of 80, you'll have to fill close to 2000 rupees in this budget. So this is done. Okay, let's go to another example. So you're buying another bike with the same price range, which is 1 lakh, and this bikes give you a mileage of 50 kmpl. So now for 25 liters, you'll have to pay 1600, which is The difference here is 2000, 1600, just 400 rupees difference, which will be always compensated by the feel and power the lesser fuel efficient bike provides. So always choose wisely. The small difference, but the feel is very important, and money is also important. But then yeah, this is just an idea that I'm giving from my end out of the research that I have done. So yeah, so according, it's not important, fuel efficiency is not at all that important, but then yeah, you like when you see the super bikes or something, I'm not talking in that, I'm talking about the day-to-day basis bikes that you use. So basically the small difference won't make much change, so go for the bike that is better in power aspects and things like that. The last and the final point is, finally buy what you like. Don't buy a bike just because it's few thousands cheaper and gives few kilometers of extra mileage. Get a bike that suits your requirement, that you have to feel it and ride it. So always, the more better feel that you get while riding the motorcycle, the more convinced you feel about the investment that you have made for it. So always think wisely and choose the best bike.